It's Eva Cartman, the host of the Dream Big podcast show, place to go to learn, laugh, and grow. I get a lot of people asking me all the time, why did I start the Dream Big podcast? Whenever I'm at an event and people find out that I have a podcast, they ask me, and we get a lot of emails from you big dreamers as well. I told bits and pieces of the story before, but I've never really given the whole story. So here it is, the untold story of why I started the Dream Big podcast and the surprising discovery I've made along the way. This is episode 112, Big Dreamers. You ready? It's time to dream big. My name is Eva Cartman. I'm part of a squad of super kids that are here to change the world. We don't believe you need to be adults to have big goals and start working towards your dreams. We believe age is just a number, and you're never too young to make a difference. We may be young, but we are not naive. We understand that achieving our big dreams will not be easy. It will take incredible dedication, hard work, and yes, massive action. There'll be ups and downs, but we embrace the challenges and relish pushing outside of our comfort zone because this is how we grow. They may not teach us these concepts in our school textbooks, but we are smart enough to know that the tools and tactics to achieve our big dreams are out there, and we are willing to do the work to seek out these skills and master them because we know that our future depends on it. We are the Big Dreamers, and it's time to dream big. Okay, it's story time, Big Dreamers. Today I'm going to tell you about why I started the Dream Big podcast and the important discovery that I made along the way. This episode is not really easy for me to record because I'm going to share some stories that are a bit embarrassing. But in order for me to tell you the full story, I need to be honest and open about the whole journey, even the parts that I wouldn't want to normally share. So here we go. You all know me as the confident, bubbly host of the Dream Big podcast who has interviewed superstar athletes like Kobe Bryant, respected leaders like General Stanley McChrystal and astronaut Chris Hadfield, influencers like Mel Robbins and Melissa Hartwig, and so many more. A few months ago, I was asked to be the co-host of an event called Made to Play at Nike headquarters in Oregon. And it was my job to pump up the crowds of thousands of people, get them moving and dancing. Never in a million years would I have imagined myself being able to interview these amazing people, yet alone be on a microphone in front of thousands of people. In fact, just a few years ago, I was so shy. You would not even believe it. I was so shy, so terrified of speaking, that I would not even want to place my order at a restaurant. Think about it. I'd be with my family, my parents, and my sister, and I was so nervous that I did not want to speak out loud to the waiter. Just one person. My parents, of course, would encourage me, and when I mustered up the courage to place my order, I would do so with a quiet voice and not even make eye contact with the waiter. Sort of like this. I would like
the macaroni and cheese, please.
In a loud restaurant, I would sometimes speak so quietly that the waiter would not hear me, so I'd have to repeat it over and over again until my parents would come to my rescue and repeat the order so that the waiter could hear it. That may not seem like such a big deal. My food did eventually get ordered, and I would eat, but my shyness also made it very difficult for me to make friends, at least at first. I remember when I switched schools between first grade and second grade. I was really upset about it. We had been going to a school that I finally got comfortable at. I had my friends. I loved the teachers and the location in the canyon. But then my parents decided that it was too far of a commute and switched me to a school that was much closer to our house. The first few weeks were really hard on me. Because I was so shy and lacked confidence, I did not go up to anybody or introduce myself. My parents knew I was so shy, so they made a few playdates for me at the beginning of the school year. At the time, I was the kind of person that would open up and make friends in that kind of situation, where it was just one-on-one for a few hours at a playdate. But I really wasn't comfortable making friends in the new school environment. When you are shy and lack confidence, it does have an impact on your life beyond being able to place an order at a restaurant. You may come across as unhappy or awkward socially, and you'll find it difficult to make friends at school. But it's more than that. It's a deeper issue inside of you. The reason why I was so shy was because I did not believe in myself. I did not believe I was interesting enough to just strike up a conversation. I didn't feel like I had anything special to offer. I knew my parents and my family loved me, so I was fun and showed personality around them, but I thought that was just because they had to love me since they were my family. If you ever felt like this before, that you're not good enough, that you're not special, you know how painful that feeling can be. My parents noticed that I was struggling making friends, and they would play more and more inspirational podcasts and audio programs when we were in the car driving. People like Tony Robbins and Brendan Burchard, Marie Forleo. If these names are not familiar to you, they're life coaches that have a huge following online. They inspire their followers to lead their best life, to get out of their comfort zone, to go after their dreams. That sounds like a familiar message, right? But here's the thing. While all those experts are very talented, their audience is adults, so they're talking to adults. Their examples are all driven towards examples that adults would relate to about business and relationships. I didn't really feel like they were speaking to me. One day, as we were listening to an episode, I asked my parents in the car, "Mom, Dad, are there any podcasts out there about these positive messages, but instead of being taught by an adult, the host is a kid?" So we looked, and we looked, and we looked, and we did not find anything. Of the tens of thousands of podcasts out there, we didn't find any kids my age or even a little older who had a positive show about being a happy, successful, fulfilled person. And then, without really thinking much about it, I blurted out, "How about I create my own podcast?" What's funny is that knowing how shy I was at the time, I really don't know what came over me to make that suggestion. I don't really think that I thought it through, that I'd be interviewing super successful people, which would require me to be friendly and talk to them. But as soon as I said, "How about I create my own podcast?" my parents said, "Yes," and they went all in to figure out what we needed to do to launch the podcast. I think they realized that this was the perfect opportunity for me to find my voice, to break out of my shell, to get out of my comfort zone. These are themes that if you're a longtime listener of the podcast, you always hear me talking about. We launched the podcast in October 2016, over 2 years ago now. I remember in my first interviews, I was super nervous, but we did some things to make it as easy as possible for me to get started. The interviews were done over the phone, so I could do the interview from the comfort of my home. We wrote out a bunch of questions and practiced them enough times so I knew I could read them without any mistakes. My mom was there with me and was able to help me out when I got off track during the interview to steer the conversation into the right direction. My first interview was with Zach George, a dog trainer who I had found on YouTube. I remember on the day of that first interview, I was still so nervous. My palms were sweaty. I felt this pit in my stomach. But we had scheduled an interview with Zach, and I knew I had to do it. And guess what? I did the interview, and it went great. Zach was as friendly as he is on his YouTube videos. My mom helped out when I was getting stuck, and we had a great conversation. The first interview was super important. It was a small first step, but it gave me the confidence that I needed to know that this is something I can do. I can be the host of my own podcast. I can ask good questions and have a conversation with someone. Now, I'm not going to tell you that from that point forward, I was completely calm and confident and that it had been smooth sailing. That first interview was done in the comfort of my bedroom with my mom by my side. But since that time, I've continued to push outside my comfort zone. And each time I've done so, it has been another small step, but important victory in my journey to really believe in myself and my abilities. Since that first interview with Zach, let me give you some examples of firsts that I've done. I've done interviews by myself. I've done interviews in person. I've interviewed two guests in a single show on multiple occasions. I've been a guest on other podcasts where instead of asking the questions, I've been responding to them. I did a live interview on stage in front of thousands of people. I'm not trying to brag, I'm just trying to make a point. If you had told me over 2 years ago, when I did not even want to place an order at a restaurant, that I could have been on stage with a microphone interviewing someone in front of thousands of people, I would have told you that was not possible. No way, no how. The truth is that you can do the impossible when you start to believe that it is possible. But I left out the coolest part of this story. When I started the podcast, it was for my own personal journey. My parents wanted me to find my voice, to believe in myself. But something magical happened along the way. The podcast became much bigger than just me. It became about you, all the big dreamers in our audience as well. We get emails all the time about how the podcast has made an impact on your life. And that has been the greatest surprise, and in my mind, the greatest achievement of the podcast. That while I'm going on this journey and learning more about myself, the podcast is transforming the lives of others as well. Thank you for listening. Thank you for being part of the journey. Thank you for being a big dreamer like me. As you listen to this untold story, I'm sure you picked up the importance of taking that first step and why believing in your potential is so important. Self-belief is a superpower. If you don't believe in yourself, then what are the chances that you're going to try? Pretty low, right? But when you believe in yourself and your potential, then everything changes. You take action and you get results, and that reinforces the belief. My parents and I have been working on a new course that we are going to launch in 2019 called the Dream Big Academy. The first section of the course is all about this concept of self-belief. Not only why it is important, but how you can train your brain to believe in yourself. And the good news is that you can do this even if you're super shy or have low confidence, like I did just a few years ago. I really want all you big dreamers to have access to this information. So my parents and I have decided to give you this first section for free for a limited time. It's essentially its own course on confidence, with over 1 hour of videos and fun worksheets as well. We have an amazing illustrator who helped us with the videos, and we are so incredibly proud of this content and know it can really help you. You can ask your parents to help you get access to this free confidence course at dreambigpodcast.com/beta. Thank you again, Big Dreamers, for being part of this amazing journey. I'm so excited for the coming year and all that we are going to learn together. Be sure to get this free confidence secrets course at dreambigpodcast.com/beta. You are going to love it. Did you love this episode? If so, please tell your friends and family about the Dream Big Podcast. You can point them to our show notes, dreambigpodcast.com/112. This is actually a great first episode for new listeners so that they can learn more about how the podcast came to be and, of course, get hooked up with the free Confidence Secrets course. As always, thank you so much for tuning in to the Dream Big Podcast. This is Eva Cartman reminding you that you have unlimited potential. Your dreams are not optional. You need to make them essential. So take massive action to turn those big dreams into reality. Live with passion, the way life is meant to be. See you next episode. Bye-bye.